Well, he looks at me with those innocent eyes and says it looks like you're wearing some kind of disguise because your hair sticks up, your shoes are untied. I hope that you got that shirt at half price and every word I say falls flat on the floor. I try to tell a joke, he's heard it before, and I don't think that I can take it no more.
Maybe later, when you're finished.
You're wearing lipstick. You weren't wearing lipstick before.
I refreshed it a bit.
Afghanistan, sorry.
Ah, Molly, coffee, thank you. What happened to the lipstick?
It wasn't working.
Really? I thought it was a big improvement. Now it's too small now.
Okay.
And I tried so hard just to figure him out, but he won't tell me what he's been thinking. And then he falls asleep on the living room couch with his sunglasses on, his tongue hanging out. Then he disappears for a week at a time, and then he shows up just like everything's fine. And I don't get what goes on in his mind, but I'm tired of hearing the same stupid lines. Why do you do what you do to me, baby? Shaking my confidence, driving me crazy. You know if I could, I'd do anything for you. Please don't ignore me, 'cause you know I adore you. You just pretend to be nice, you at least pretend to be nice. You could just pretend to be nice. Everything in my life would be
eyes, then there's his underwear. Visible above the waistline, very visible, very particular brand. That plus the extremely suggestive fact that he just left his number under this dish here. I'd say you better break it off now and save yourself a pain.